just about set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Penn State is lined up to kick the ball off first, and we are ready to go. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. Tackle made the 27-yard line. The Cougars and their coaching staff, Kirk, just happy to have a guy like this in the program. Their offense really clicks when he's playing
well. Well, I think it gives them the diversity that they're looking for. I mean, at times they're going to run the football. Other times they're going to try to air it out. When you have one guy that gets so much attention on the outside, it just seems to open up other aspects of their offensive attack. And they've done a good job as an offensive staff of putting together a good plan. And I'm sure we're going to see it again today.
From their own 27-yard line, it's second down. They come out in a five-wide set. Throws a bullet over the middle. Tackle made around the 40-yard line. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
From their own 47-yard line, it's second down. And they'll get him in the backfield.
You know, a lot of times coaches look to linebackers for leadership on defense. And on that tackle, he showed you why that's the case.
Catch and has a first down. He gets hit out of bounds at the 43.
He looked pretty cool back there. Even with the outside linebacker blitzing, he made an accurate throw, and the result is a new set of downs.
He's scrambling. And they make the stop at the 43-yard line. From the 43-yard line, second down. Receiver, and he can't hang on. And this is the eighth play of the drive. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. They hook up over the middle, and he's taken down at the 34-yard line.
That was a well-designed and executed pattern, but on third down and forever, it just wasn't enough.
It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. They're all tied in on the line here on fourth and short. And he's tackled around the 31-yard line.
They're eating up a lot of field on this drive. I'm really impressed with their ball control.
10th play of the drive. Ground incomplete. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 31. He's on the run. He's at the 20. And he tackles him hard at the 16. We're at the 12th play of the drive. Play action. Fires to his fullback. No good. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 16-yard line. The 10. Gets out to around the 6. And this is the 14th play of the drive. receiver, touchdown.
A good football team has to consistently be able to capitalize when they're in the red zone.
So a 14-play, 71-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. Brigham Young ready to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. From their own 38-yard line, it's first down.
Black five, black five, orange three.
The cavalry's coming. He gets sacked on the play. Great play by the defense.
Ooh, that time they came with the blitz, and the linebacker was able to get free and come away with the sack.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. And he just gets rid of it.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
And catch there, but still not enough for the first down.
That's not an easy conversion here on third down for the offense. All the defense has to do is stay back, keep everything in front of them, come up and make a tackle.
The punt upcoming, and they're going to come after this one.
Decent effort. He's not the type of guy to call a fair catch very often. He does have the ability to make guys miss.
I think we saw the effects of what a long drive can do to a defense the last time this offense was out on the field. They took that football and drove the length of the field to put points up on the board. And I think it really started to affect not only just the psyche of this defense, but maybe even the conditioning where they started to get a little bit fatigued.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 42. Brigham Young is up a score. And they get nice yardage on that run.
Gain of 4 on one play. That makes it second and 6.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
With the tackle. That's good for a gain of 5 yards.
So it's third down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down. Runs right for a nice gain.
That's a genius system. That makes it first and 10.
Hands it to the back. He makes his way out to about the 35. Not a lot of offense in quarter number one, but nonetheless, we've got a close game. The Cougars in front, 7-0. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. They'll give it off here. Nice run there as they work the outside. First and 10. Ball on the 29.
He's going to try and scramble. And they got it. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds, and those receivers might have been open.
This is the eighth play of this drive. Brigham Young is up by a touchdown. He's at the 20. He's taken down around the 9-yard line. And smell the end zone as they look to extend this lead. Slings it. That was a well-drawn-up play for the wideout.
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 22. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Quick throw. He's tackled at the 28. Away here on second down. Finds his man. First down. Brought down around the 38-yard line. We've got a second and five. Ball on the 43-yard line.
Has to do a better job of avoiding the rush because sacks can be real drive killers.
The sack makes this a fourth and very long. And they're coming after this punter. They get this one off and it's a beauty. Down at the 38. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Now he tries to buy some time. He's at midfield. And down he goes to the 38-yard line. And he has a huge gain.
Yeah, and I like the decision-making ability of this quarterback. He looks and looks. He sees nothing. He didn't get rattled. He sees some green in front of him, and he takes off. Ends up with a great run.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 38. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. Nice run there. Nice gain of around 7 yards on that delay.
tackle.
Around the 29-yard line.
The running back gets two on the carry.
It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. Bring him down at about the 15-yard line. And that's their third first down of the drive.
The defense needs to figure out a way to stop them, or else they're going to have no problem putting points on the board.
Makes it out to about the 7. A gain of 8 on the carry. Short yardage situation here. It's second down and 1. The Cougars are going to call their second timeout. It's 3 touchdown passes this half.
The quarterback is just having a great game so far. He's had absolutely no problem finding the end zone.
And he adds the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being. Steps out of bounds, right around the 28-yard line. From their own 28-yard line, second down. They go with a screen here, and the halfback's got it. Tackle made at about the 39-yard line. The stop right around midfield. What a play.
Boy, solid job there by the quarterback, recognizing the defensive coverage and delivering the ball to the open receiver.
Throws complete. He's got space to work. He's pushed out of bounds at the 40. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. Taken down around the 27-yard line.
Excellent job by this young quarterback of making the defense pay for bringing both outside linebackers. That's composure right there.
He goes out of bounds around the 25-yard line. Second and 9. Ball on the 25-yard line. Quick throw. Quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown. He makes the PAT. They line up to kick this one away. It's fielded at the 2. He's to the 20. He's got the corner. Tackle made at the 38. The Cougars' offensive staff, I think, has done a good job of keeping their wide receiver in the game. Even though he's not having great stats, he's part of it, and the rest of the team now is picking up his stats.
Well, this offense is still putting points on the board, and I think at times they're actually using the wide receiver, the go-to man who's drawing so much attention, really as a decoy, open up other avenues of this offense. We've seen other receivers make some plays. They're running the football. So it'll be interesting to see what kind of adjustments this defense makes to try to slow down these other members of this offense. And who knows, maybe that can open it back up for that marquee receiver.
Now he's scrambling. Decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. And he's tackled at the 43. He scrambled. He's taken down at about the 35. He scrambles there for about 8 yards. The field goal unit's out on the field, and they're going to try to get these guys 3 points before halftime. Kicks up, and he missed it off the upright. These guys came up with a touchdown on their last drive, and they'll be hoping for another 6 on the board here.
You can bet this defense made some adjustments on the sideline, though. I don't know if they can stop the passing attack, but they need to at least be able to slow it down.
He's going to air it long. Intercepted. We played a half. The Cougars in front, 21-7.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Steve Davis, David Pollack here in the studio, as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. It is my job to come in and rain on a parade. I know everything's gone right. I know they have all the momentum. I know that every little detail of the game plan has gone exactly as scripted.
But,
overconfidence, too happy, too satisfied. How big a problem is that in the second half?
But you always have the excitement coming in the first half of a ball game, and you think it's going to be close when teams like this are evenly matched. But that doesn't mean you can lose your edge. That doesn't mean you can get complacent. A lot of times we see passion and energy in the first half and it starts to wither away. They gotta make sure that they keep the energy up, continue to make plays. Don't think that you're there, because we've seen momentum switch like that. As soon as somebody flips a switch, it's hard to get it going back in the other direction. So you gotta take advantage of these opportunities.
That's gonna do it for David and me here in the studio. Time to get you back to the game. Brad and Kirk ready to take you home in the second half.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. Heading for the corner. And he's taken down at the 30. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game.
Boy, Brad, that was a big hit on the quarterback.
I'm going to be interested to see how he responds from this hit, and whether or not he comes after his offensive lineman and challenges them to start playing a little bit better.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack. It's second and long.
Go for it!
Fires incomplete. He was looking for the tight end. He was way out in front on that one.
Yeah, there was no chance for the tight end to catch up to that ball there.
Scrambling around, and they bring him down for a sack on the play.
A defensive end with this kind of speed is an offensive force nightmare. He's got the ability to collapse the pocket on any given pass play. And as a play caller, you constantly have to be aware of him. Whether you're going to roll away from him or you're going to chip with a tight end or a running back, you're constantly concerned and aware of a big, strong defensive end.
After the sack, it's now fourth and long. Certainly, they don't have the return on here. tackled at the 47-yard line. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. He's tackled at the 27.
Number 84 with the tackle at the 27-yard line. First down.
From the 27-yard line, it's first down. Carries the ball for a nice game.
That'll bring up second and three.
Again, he'll get the call. They'll knock him down for a loss. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. First and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
And he hits him hard at the 6.
That brings him second and goal.
Second down and goal. Ball on the 6. And he makes it out to about the 5-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That makes his third and goal.
Fourth down. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. He gets it up, and it's through the uprights. Brigham Young gets set to kick this one away. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 23-yard line. The Cougars continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
Their last drive resulted in a punt, so let's see if they can put together something a little more promising here.
Down 2 possessions. This offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
Got a man. Watch out here. At the 30. Knocked out of bounds at the 23.
That's just a great call by the coordinator there, going to the air on first down.
So let's see how the defense responds now. It's first down and 10. Inside the 10. What a play to set him up with a first and goal.
He gets another set of downs and, more importantly, opens up a whole host of play calling possibilities for the coaching staff.
First down. Chance for 3 or 7 here. First and goal inside the 5. Defense stacked in tight here. They're not done yet. And So they punch it in on the ground, Kirk Herbstreit.
Great job up front by the offensive line. They get a good, strong push that allowed the runner to get it in there for the touchdown.
And he converts the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. And he's hammered down. Well, the defense held him to 3 on their last possession. Pitching a shutout on this drive would be even better. Fires it out. And down he goes around the 21-yard line.
No gain. That makes it 2nd and 10.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 21. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a 5 wide outlook. Makes it to the 22-yard line.
A 1-yard gain by the halfback.
That'll bring up 3rd and 8.
Over the middle to his tailback. That's a great tackle. The 24-yard line.
That brings us 4th and 7.
And down he goes at the 42.
I was really impressed with their last series. They came out with a focus on the passing game, and the offense got the job done. We'll see if they have the same strategy here.
There's a strike complete. And he's leveled at the 46. From the 46-yard line, 1st down. It's not over yet, folks. We head to the 4th quarter. 24-14, BYU. Back in this very pivotal 4th quarter. Down now, and they need to get it down to the 36. Fires out quickly to the tailback. He's tackled in the open field. Safety with the interception.
He seemed a little hesitant on that throw, and that left the defender time to break on the ball and pick it off.
From their own 49-yard line, it's 1st down. Tackle at the 43-yard line.
It's 2nd and 2.
Tight right. Four down.
Hey, go, Mike Ford.
Now he tries to buy some time. They'll bring him down right around the 30. First and 10. Ball on the 30-yard line. Pass to the end zone. Got it. Touchdown, Brigham Young.
This offense just has so many weapons to defend. They've got some genuine playmakers.
extra point. Brigham Young is lining up to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
The Cougars have really been all over the place. They're playing like a defense possessed.
I love to watch a defense just pin its ears back and just fly to the football. They are playing with a reckless attitude, and it's really paid off because it set up their offense to be able to score points.
Here's a step in the maturation of a young quarterback. How does he respond to throwing an interception on that last drive?
So much in football is about how you respond to adversity. Moving forward after a turnover is a perfect example of that.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
So the sack makes this a second and long. The catch and gets out of bounds. Throws quickly, and it's almost intercepted.
Well, you want to do everything you can to keep the ball out of the hands of these receivers, so that was a really good effort.
From their own 37-yard line, it's second down. He's out of bounds at about the 41. Throws into coverage, just picked off. Another interception by this defense, and their sideline is really fired up.
Yeah, they didn't want this quarterback to be able to beat them through the air. And with three interceptions, I would say they are winning that battle right now.
From their own 44-yard line, first down, just under three to go in regulation. Tackle made right around the 46-yard line.
That'll make it second and inches.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run. From the 39-yard line, first down. He's at the 30, and he's taken down at about the 27-yard line. He is drilled at the 17. From the 17-yard line, it's first down. And now he's got room to run. Touchdown, BYU. Big time touchdown on the ground for what looks to be the score that puts this one on ice. He makes the PAT. Brigham Young kicked this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 30-yard line. I'm sure there are a lot of fans out there hoping for a miracle, but I seriously doubt we're going to see one today. Excellent open field tackle.
after a play like that, I wouldn't be the least bit surprised if they went to the air again.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. And he's tackled at the 47. The Cougars coaching staff, Kirk, do they start wondering, hey, are we going to have trouble with our star player after the struggles he had today?
Well, I think the coaching staff's got to be happy that this team was able to win the football game and overcome the fact that their star player didn't have a great game. But I think making adjustments and changing the game plan because their star didn't deliver, I think that would be a big mistake.
Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.